Where do I park? I'm gonna show you and also reveal rules I live by to keep myself safe as a solo female traveler. So hop in bed with me. Why do I always say these sexually charged things? Because together we're gonna go on a wild by the mile ride. Hey everyone, I'm Liz Bryant, or Wild by the Mile on Instagram. And you can see that my bed is out and I'm sitting on it because today's episode is all about parking. A side note, it is hot as shit inside this van right now. I think it's like 90 degrees outside and I can't turn the fan on or the mic will pick it up. Oh, drink break. Oh my God, it's so hot. First, this just happened, so it's fresh on my mind and I want to tell you all about it. It is something that any of you, if you have a van or if you don't have a van, can take full advantage of. I flew out to Oklahoma for 5 days. If you saw my latest post, it was to buy my mom a car. I Googled cheap airport parking and lo and behold, a website popped up, cheapairportparking.org. So I picked the Sheraton for $9 a night. You can't even park at the Sheraton as an overnight guest for $9. It's $35 a night. I flew out at 7 a.m., so I parked there actually the night before, slept in the van, no issues. My return flight arrived at 10 p.m. Again, slept in the van, no issues. So my dad always tells me they make housing for a reason. It is unsafe to live in a van because someone can break in. So this is what I said to him one time. If you live in the same place night after night, day after day, you're actually an easier target because a burglar knows your routine. Now, another comment I have heard is you must do this so that you can avoid rent or property tax. You don't want to pay high rent in San Diego. That's actually not true. I choose van life because I am restless and I want to see the world. Not because I'm trying to pinch pennies, not because I'm trying to save money. So I was shocked to see how much I owed to update my California registration this year. I paid $593 or $94, just under $600 to update the Sprinter registration this year. With all those misconceptions out of the way, I want to show you common places I park at night. This includes campgrounds, BLM land, hotel parking lots, neighborhood streets, and sprinkle in a few truck stops and Walmart parking lots, just a time or two, not that often. My first choice, BLM or public land, also known as Bureau of Land Management, which is essentially free land. Spots are beautiful, they're in nature, and they're quiet. And the great news, you meet other van lifers. Now, if I am in the city and don't have time to drive around to scope out a spot, I feel safest in a hotel parking lot. If I am in a city where I know the area, I spot out neighborhood streets where other residents park parallel. Parallel parking is key because the goal is to blend in. Your reaction is probably, why the hell do you think you can blend in a tall, high roof Sprinter? Well, you would be surprised. People really don't pay attention. An option I am grateful for, but only use in a pinch, are truck stops or Walmart parking lots. This is typically when I'm driving long hours, 8 to 9 hours. So these spots are noisy with travelers coming in and going out at all times of night. Even if you have all the curtains out, there is still a lot of light pollution coming in. But they are safe, which is nice in a pinch. Here are the rules I live by to keep myself safe as a solo female traveler. Cell phone service, keys by my bed, and the front of the van facing out. So I choose to have cell phone service in case I need to call 911 or in case I need to call my parents because there's an emergency. My keys are always on this quartz countertop right here, which my head is right here. So I just have to reach up, grab the keys, and, you know, like climb into the front seat. And the van faces out. The van front faces out specifically, so I don't have to back up, turn around, and maneuver to leave a spot. This is all typically gonna happen if you have to do this at, you know, 3 a.m., 5 a.m., when you're kind of, I don't wanna say delirious, but you're out of sorts. You're like, someone's been knocking on the window, like, what's going on? You're in a dead sleep, and you just grab your keys right by your head and right by your bed. You climb in the front seat, the van is facing out, start the ignition, and you drive off. and act like it never even happened. That's kind of how I gauge a good spot. If someone knocks on the door or there's people watching you kind of like suspect, it's probably a place you shouldn't park. So someone has knocked on the van to wake me up in the middle of the night or the early morning a handful of times. I wait, I just like lay here quietly and I look around and I wait for them to walk off. Because I am not keen on confrontation, I get it, they don't want their neighborhood turning into a van life village. So I wait till they walk off before they call the police or before they call a tow truck. And that's when I hop in the driver's seat and drive away. Thank you guys so much for watching. And next Sunday, let's talk about what I would do differently if I built another van. If you have a question, of course, message me on Instagram at wildbythemile or leave it in the comments below. See you next Sunday at 7 p.m. West Coast time. Bye.